The Hopewell Culture National Historical Park protects the prehistoric remains of Native Americans who flourished in the eastern United States between 200 BC and AD 500. Archaeologists can tell us that the Hopewell hunted, fished, gathered wild foods, and cultivated plants. However, no one knows what name this group of people called themselves. Following the excavation in 1891 of an extensive earthwork site in Ross County, the name Hopewell was given to this culture. It honored Mordecai Hopewell, who owned the farm where part of the excavated earthwork existed. There are five distinct land units of the Hopewell National Park. The only fully restored site is the ceremonial and burial grounds of the Mound City Group. It's a 13-acre rectangular earthen enclosure with at least 23 mounds. Each burial mound started as a large ceremonial building with a plastered clay floor. Inside, fires burned in clay basins and ceremonies were conducted. When the ceremony was a funeral, the Hopewell cremated the body within the building. The ashes were entombed on the floor beneath a small mound of clay. At some point, the building would be purposely dismantled. Then the mound construction began. About 100 cremated remains were found at Mound City Group. Works of art were placed by each burial and can be seen at the Visitor Center's museum. You can walk the sacred grounds on your own, reading the interpretive signs, or you can take a guided tour. Park rangers are more than happy to answer questions and offer hands-on demonstrations.
Now I'm going to show you what they used is something called an atlatl, or spear thrower. The arrow has a hollow base and it fits on that peg. And the atlatl has a spear holder like that. You hold it like this.
There you go. And you're going to step forward with your back foot. Yeah, as you do it. Yeah.
Wow!
Mound City Group was a much smaller complex than the other four earthworks of the park. The Hopewell Mound Group covered 300 acres and was the location of Mordecai Hopewell's farm. This complex included 29 burial mounds, one being the largest mound the Hopewell ever built, which measured 500 feet long and 33 feet high. Most of the earthworks were destroyed by farming, but remnants of enclosure walls are still visible. You can visit this site and walk the 2.5-mile interpretive trail as you learn more about the Hopewell culture. The Seip earthworks originally contained 2 miles of embankment wall enclosing over 120 acres. It contained the shapes of two large circles and a precise square with astronomical alignments. The prime agricultural land led to plowing, which has flattened most of this park unit. But you can still see a reconstructed mound and a portion of reconstructed wall, a portion of the original wall, and remnants of Hopewell buildings. Among the artifacts found by archaeologists in 1925 is the famous clay Seip head. It's on display at the Ohio History Center in Columbus. The Seip unit was named after the old Seip farm, and the old Seip farmhouse still stands. The last two units of the National Historical Park are the High Banks Works and the Hopeton Earthworks. Each area is closed to the public. However, permits may be issued at Mound City Group's Visitor Center. Continued cultivation has reduced the earthworks to less than 5 feet in height in most places. It's an honor to have this national park in Ohio. It's even a greater honor to have an entire culture be named after a fellow Buckeye. While you're traveling around Ohio, make the Hopewell Culture National Historical Park a travel destination.